Hey, Viking fans, this is Keith Millard, and you are listening to the Onebar and Lupicus Show. Go Vikes!
All right, welcome back to the Onebar and Lupicus Show. I am Onebar, and ESPN just came out ranking all NFL teams, offensive lines, best to worst. And I've been meaning to do a video on this. I'm going to crank it out right now as far as where the Vikings rank. There are some people out there, Vikings fans especially, just not very happy with the rating, which I think they might be batshit crazy. Because this is a more than fair rating, because the Vikings, as we know, their offensive line is a big old question mark, and it was dog shit last year. Before we get into that, subscribe to the channel, like the videos here every damn day, talking Vikings. Also, help us get up to that 3,500 subscribers. We are almost there, and support the channel, Patreon link down below. All right, let's do this. So ESPN, let's just cut to the chase. They ranked the Vikings offensive line heading into the season 24th overall, 24 out of 32. Put that in perspective. Last year, the Vikings ranked their offensive line, finished the season, PFF ranking ranked them 26th overall. So a huge, huge leap. ESPN has all the faith in the world that the Vikings are going to be two teams better. I believe they had the Browns number one and the Giants dead ass last. But the Vikings were very close to last. So let's look at this. A lot of Vikings fans are just not seeing how we can be 24, how we can't be higher. Let's just crank down the list. So last year, we arguably lost one of our second best offensive line. Brian O'Neill is fantastic. Riley Reiff, he might not have been overly fantastic. He might not have had a great year, but he had a good year, and he's gonzo. So we know Riley Reiff is gone. We're replacing him with a baby fresh rookie, Christian Darrisaw. All the hope in the world for Darrisaw, but we know offensive linemen, especially rookies, second-year guys, they have quite a bit of a learning curve. So Darrisaw is not going to be this savior that comes in and is just all of a sudden a fantastic anchor to this offensive line where he holds down that left side. If he comes and does that, I will apologize, but we got to be realistic with what we got. I see him having some good games. I see him having some great moments, but I also see him having some very gross, disgusting games and some very ugly moments as well. He's a rookie. It just happens. Nothing against him. So we replace Riley Reiff with him. And also we are looking at moving Ezra Cleveland, another position change, and most likely putting a rookie starting right guard in Wyatt Davis, which is exciting. But again, like Darrisaw, we'll talk about this in a minute. There's going to be some ugly moments, big learning curves. So really the fact that ESPN ranked us two spots higher when we lost our starting left tackle and we're replacing, yes, Dakota Dozier with a rookie. It's very surprising that they actually moved us up and they didn't move us down two spots. So overall, ESPN, thank you. I think you threw us a bone there. We'll see how it shakes out afterwards, but let's look at this offensive line quick. We already went over Darrisaw. Going to be some bumps in the road. Ezra Cleveland makes yet another position change. And just going back to Darrisaw, to put that in a little bit more context, last year, Andrew Thomas was the top left tackle drafted number four, I believe, to the Giants. And he had a very rough season. And he was the first tackle off the board in an offensive line group that was pretty damn good. Darrisaw, come on, baby. All right, so Ezra Cleveland, he is moving yet again to the left side, to left guard, from not only going from left tackle in college to right guard last year, but now he is going to left guard for the Vikings. So again, this will probably be his final stop, at least with the Minnesota Vikings on this offensive line, but there's going to be some bumps in the road anyways. And he was pretty shaky last year as it was, but it could be another season of just Ezra Cleveland getting to learn, getting to know what's going on there. Center Garrett Bradbury. This is Garrett Bradbury's moment. This is the most important year of his career. He's already 26 years old, which is crazy because it seems like he was just drafted yesterday. But let's be real. I've been on the Garrett Bradbury train just waiting, thinking, you know, he's going to pop. It's going to happen. But he's been ranked one of the worst centers in the league 2 years in a row. And when you're a center drafted in round one, you're not drafted to be a top 15, a top 20 center. You are drafted to be a top 10 center damn near day one. And he has not done that. And he has been getting just crushed by big defensive tackles, pushing his ass back in the Kirk Cousins. This is Garrett Bradbury's time. He needs to show up, or he's going to go down as a big old fat bust, which many people are already labeling him as. He needs to be a top 20 center. That's it. That's not asking a ton, but for him, for what he's done so far, it is asking a ton. So Bradbury, this is your moment. Really, there's no signs or no reason why any Vikings fans or myself should think that that's going to happen because he hasn't shown it. We'll see. Deep down, I'm still a Garrett Bradbury guy, but I'm starting to get a little realistic with him. Wyatt Davis, like we said with Darisaw, Davis is most likely going to win this job. If it's not him, it's going to be Dakota Dozier. It's going to be Dakota Grosser. So regardless of who this is, let's hope it's Wyatt Davis. Let's hope he has some good moments. Let's hope he shows something for the future. But again, there's no reason why putting Wyatt Davis in here is also going to make the Vikings offensive line way, way better year one. And then we know what we got on the right side. We got Brian O'Neill. He is not elite, but he is damn good. Hopefully they get him buttoned up, sign that contract, extend him to be a Viking for the next 4 or 5 years. But we know our offensive line in a nutshell, but we have to be realistic going into this season that this offensive line is probably going to be pretty close on par with what we saw last year, with a caveat, I don't know if I've ever said that word in my life, that this is for the future. They are going to be damn good in a couple of years if guys like Wyatt Davis, Darisaw, pop, and Ezra Cleveland gets nice and comfy at that spot with Brian O'Neill coming back. So ESPN, like I said, where I land on it, I think they threw us a bone. I think we should have actually been ranked worse. So I'll take that 24. Let me know down in the rankings. What do you think about that ranking, 24th overall for the offensive line? And where do you think the Vikings should have fallen? Remember, subscribe, like the videos here every damn day. Talking purple. Boom.